नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट स्टैंडर्ड 6 सोशल साइंस, चैप्टर नंबर 15 गवर्नमेंट।
नाउ आवर न्यू टॉपिक इज टाइप्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट। आवर कंट्री हैज डेमोक्रेटिक सिस्टम ऑफ गवर्नर। सो आवर कंट्री इज ए democratic system. All the countries in the world do not have democratic system. In India there is only in a democratic system, and all the world, in the all over the world, all the countries, there is no system for democratic. Let's understand the types of government found in the various system operating in the countries around the world. In there is a first one is democratic government. In this system of government, people elected their representative through voting. How it is in the system of government? In India there is a system of government, but how we elect our representative? By giving them vote. In the election time we give them vote, and by giving vote, so we through the vote we selected our representative by voting. The government is formed by the winning candidate. So how government become to winning by the voting? So the winning candidates become the winner, and that one is make the government. Government function, keeping the public in the center in the democracy. Local government, state government and central government are formed through the election. So through the election we decided and we elect our representative, and there is a three type of government. First one is state, local government, state government, and third one is national, central government. In those countries, chief minister or a prime minister is elected by the elected representative in the democracy. In not only in India, other country also, if there is a democracy system. So how they do? In some countries, chief minister or prime minister, yani means PM, is elected by the elected representative. Who is the elected representative? They choose from the them. So in some countries of the world, presidential democracy is seen. In India, there is parliamentary democracy. So in the government, how we choose our representative? By giving them voting, and the government is formed by winning candidates. And the function of the keeping the public in the center means to keep the public, there is what is right and rules and regulation, what is benefit for the people, to keeping the public in the center in the democracy. So in the democracy we keep the people in the center. So what is the public demand? What is their right? What is their wish? We keep this in the center, and then we decide. Then there is a three type of governments: local government, state government, and third one is central government. And some countries, chief minister or prime minister are elected by the representative, and some countries of the world, presidential democracy is also seen. In India, there is a parliamentary democracy. It is said for democracy that government is run by the people directly or indirectly through election. So we can say that our government is run by the people. How? Maybe sometime we already learned that we keep the people in the center, then take the decision. So we make the decision for the, in the keep the people. That democracy government is run by the people directly or indirectly through the election, because through the election we select our representative. So in the center they keep the people, public in the center, and then they take the decision. So democracy, that government is run by the people directly or indirectly through the election. There is no alternative. Alternative means no other choice for democracy for protection and promotion of human rights. So there is no other choice for protection, means protect the people and human rights. What is our right? That one. Thus, democratic government is very important for all round development and right of the people. So in the democratic, so first number given to the people, they keep the center in the public and then take the decision. So in this, there is no other choice for democracy, for protection of human rights. Thus, democratic government is very important role in the development of and the right of the people. In democratic government, people play an important role. Government also works for people. The tenure means period of time of elected government in our country is for 5 years. So government is working for the people and that one time is for 5 years. In a democratic government, people elect their representative by voting. The government is formed from the member of majority party from those represented. So democratic government is elect by their voting. Giving voting and from the government is formed. But from the members, majority party or from the representative. A democratic government takes over the governance of the country on behalf of the people. They can take over the governance of the country on behalf of the people. The final line of the power in this government is in the hands of the people. So final line, it is in people's hands. A democratic government is governed directly or indirectly by the people. And in this government, elections are held at fixed time. It is 5 years. Our topic is communist government. So in this topic, we will learn what is communist government. Communist government means community to about related to government. In this type of governance, the importance of equality or similarity is given to all. Means in this type of governance means communist government. Related to communist governance, in this government, the equality means equal to all people, poor, rich, educated, uneducated, which type of people, they are given equality and similarity. Means same, all person are same for government. This is similarity and equality is given to all. The government working or operating on this basis of communism manages the system of governance on the basis of equality and similarity. So main thing of communist government is that there is a similarity and equality for all people. So the government working or operating by this rule, equality and similarity. In many countries of the world, government working on the ideology of the communism is seen. Ideology means principle of belonging to an individual group. Individual means one person, maybe one person or there, means personally. So many countries in the world, many countries, the government is also working like an individual. It is also seen. And in some countries, maybe in some country there are ideology work and in other some country. Remaining some countries, the world communist government is formed through election. So this one is working personally, individually or sometime. In other country also, we can see that there are also elected by the people. There is an election. So people give vote them and selected their person. There are many examples of some rulers forming a government based on the communist ideology and becoming the sole ruler in the long run. So there are many examples in the world who is governor, government is communist. So there are some are individual and some are chosen by the election. So in this there are many of examples are there that government based on the community ideology and also becoming the soul. Soul means individual. Soul means individual personally are also ruler in the long run. The administration and governance is done considering economical, ideological and intellectual. Intellectual means understanding. Equality among the workers, laborers and exploited. Exploited means achievement of people. So there is also economical and ideological. Intellectual means understanding equality. Understanding equality among where? Among the worker. Worker means labor means worker who are working for less money. So that one are labor workers. Then exploited means achievement people. Today some rulers who rule individually or forcibly. Forcibly means by force or powerfully. Have left communism and adopted monarchy or dictatorship. Dictatorship means a government where all over supreme authority all are on the kings. So the in some rulers who rule individually. Individually means personally who is worth means they are forcibly means by force or powerful. By they have also power, so powerful have left communism and adopted monarchy. Monarchy means king or dictatorship means their government were all over the supreme authority for all the things are also seen. Communist ideology is known in the world as the leftist ideology. Leftist ideology means a person who hold views associated with political left. So communist ideology is also known the world as a person who is hold views associated with the political views. Communist government. In communist government, equal and special importance is given to all the communist government. In communist government, equal and similarly, special importance are given to the communist government. It manages the governance system on the basis of equality and similarity. So what is the basis of the communist government? That one is it manages the governance system by on the basis of equality and similarity. In some countries of the world, so in some countries of the world, communist government are formed through election. In the some country of the government, the communist government are formed through the election, like our democracy system. After a long period, the leader of that government takes over all the powers of the state and become a sole ruler. In communist government, every section of society is governed economically on the basis of equality and similarity. Here also we learn it manages the governance system on the basis of equality and similarity. Same thing in communist government, every section of the society is governed economically on the basis of equality and similarity. The ideology of communist government is known as the leftist ideology in the world.
Thank you for joining us.